Hi, welcome to this Sonarworks support video covering the integration with Universal Audio. In this support tutorial, we will demonstrate how to apply SoundID reference calibration profiles to Apollo X devices using the Apollo monitor correction. We will walk you through the setup stage, including system and license requirements and free trial options. We will also look into the functionality and configuration tips, troubleshooting, performance figures, and other frequently asked questions. With the Apollo Monitor Correction add-on, calibration profiles can now be applied directly to Apollo X hardware DSP using the UAD console app, skipping the conventional software-based calibration workflow entirely and freeing up the computer resources. The integration supports both headphone and speaker profiles, including calibrated bass management for stereo speakers with a subwoofer. Multi-channel profiles are also supported. The integration supports Gen 1 and Gen 2 Apollo X devices. All models run one speaker profile and at least one headphone profile, except Apollo X16 and X16D, which have no headphone outputs. Apollo X6 and X8 models support two headphone profiles. To start with, software components have to be up to date to use the integration. Open the UA Connect app and install the latest updates for UAD console and UAD software. The newest version of SoundID Reference is available in the Sonarworks Download Center linked in the description. These components require Mac OS 11 Big Sur or newer or Windows 10 or newer. Older operating systems are not supported. The integration requires a permanent SoundID Reference-based license and, additionally, the Apollo Monitor Correction add-on license. All calibration profile types are supported, depending on your base license. Headphones license, apply headphone profiles, speakers and headphones license, apply headphone profiles and 2.0 stereo speaker profiles, including calibrated bass management for subwoofer setups. Multi-channel license, apply headphone profiles, stereo speaker profiles, and multi-channel speaker profiles up to 9.1.6 Atmos. For existing SoundID reference license owners, the Apollo Monitor Correction add-on, or AMC for short, is available in the Sonarworks store separately. For new users, license bundle options with the AMC add-on included are available on the SoundID reference pricing page, linked in the description below. To register your software license, log into your Sonarworks account, click on Register a New License, and enter the license key. Each product license key has to be registered separately, the SoundID reference-based license and the AMC add-on license. With the registration completed, activate both licenses on your device to get started. To start a free trial, one of the following trial options will be available in your account. For new users, use the SoundID reference for multi-channel with add-ons trial. If you already own a SoundID reference-based license, use the Apollo Monitoring Correction add-on trial. With the software up and running, calibration profiles can be applied using the Apollo integration mode in the SoundID reference app. The integration mode is indicated by the link symbol in the output panel. It appears automatically when a compatible Apollo X device is detected, showing the available monitor correction outputs. These outputs correspond directly to the monitor correction slots in UAD console, with a number of headphone and speaker slots available, depending on your Apollo X model. If the integration mode is not detected, either a required software update is missing or your Apollo model isn't compatible. If this is the case, go back and double-check the requirements. Note that your Apollo may also appear in a regular non-integrated mode if used previously with the SoundID reference virtual output. Remove it via the three-dot menu to prevent any conflicts. We will return to the app and see how everything works after applying a profile. To export a headphone calibration profile, click on the Headphones 1 preset and proceed to add a new headphone profile. For this demo, we'll use Sennheiser HD650. Click Yes Continue to confirm. The profile is now loaded into the Headphones 1 preset. We can adjust DSP settings before applying the profile, but for now, we'll use the default flat target and revisit adjustments later. Click Apply Profile to Apollo X to export the profile. Once applied, we can open the UAD console and navigate to Monitor Correction for details. In Headphone Correction, we can see the applied calibration profile name, correction curve, and three control buttons. Safe Headroom prevents clipping and is recommended to keep enabled. Bypass temporarily disables calibration for A-B comparison. When correction is active, clicking Enable turns off correction and unloads it from Apollo DSP. Open SoundID can be used to quickly access the SoundID reference app. Note that Apollo Monitor Correction cannot be applied to Apollo alternative monitor outputs, digital mirror outputs, cues, or cue mirrors. let's return to SoundID Reference and apply a 2.0 stereo speaker profile. Click on the speaker slot to load a profile. If you have used speaker calibration before, simply load your existing speaker profile. To create a new profile, first ensure the monitor mode and console is set to stereo. Click Select your calibration profile and proceed to Create a new speaker profile to open the SoundID Reference Measure app. Notice the link icon at the bottom left corner indicating that the Apollo X device has been identified and the integrated measurement flow is engaged. This means that your speaker layout has been read from the UAD console automatically. If you are unfamiliar with the speaker measurement process, see our dedicated video tutorial for it, linked in the description below. Once the profile is loaded in the app, apply it to the Apollo, navigate to the main monitor section in the console to view the loaded profile details. The interface offers the same controls as before, with additional speaker settings, including bass management, which is also supported for 2.0 stereo setups. Let's dive deeper and see what it has to offer. While calibrated bass management is easily available for multi-channel setups, the integrated functionality allows for separate subwoofer calibration and bass management on 2.0 stereo setups using a regular SoundID reference for speakers and headphones license, also known as the stereo license. To set this up, a new stereo calibration profile will have to be created with bass management enabled and the subwoofer connected separately to the dedicated LFA output channel on the Apollo. To achieve this, the UAD console will extract the subwoofer calibration data from the stereo profile using the integrated measurement flow. Note that for full multi-channel calibration from 2.1 up to 9.1.6, a SoundID reference for multi-channel license will be required. Now let's configure calibrated bass management for a stereo system. First, we need to connect the subwoofer to the dedicated subwoofer output on our Apollo X interface. For Apollo Twin X and Apollo X4, it's the line out 4. For Apollo X6, it's line out 6. For all Apollo X8 and X16 models, the dedicated subwoofer output is line out 8. Once that is done, make sure to disable the currently loaded speaker profile and the monitor controller, set your monitor mode to stereo, and enable bass management. If you have a specific preference for the satellite crossover, make sure to adjust it now, as these settings will be integrated into the new calibration profile and will not be available for adjustments later on. Otherwise, the measurement process is identical to that of a standard stereo speaker setup. Simply follow the directions in the Measure app to complete the process. With the measurements completed, we can load the new calibration profile in SoundID Reference and apply it to our Apollo. A successfully applied profile with bass management can be confirmed by accessing the Speaker Utilities tab in console. The subwoofer icon will be displayed in the layout. If you see a bass management mismatch error message when loading the calibration profile in SoundID Reference, the measured calibration profile does not have the bass management data. This can happen if the dedicated subwoofer output channel wasn't used on the Apollo or if one of the other steps was missed. Double-check the configuration before starting the measurement process. Multi-channel speaker profiles are measured and applied similarly as before, with a couple of additional checks. We will be using a 5.1 speaker setup for this demonstration. First, we need to set the monitor mode to 5.1 surround in the console, with bass management enabled if needed, and adjust the satellite crossover before measuring, as changes won't be possible after applying the profile. Second, ensure to enable the LFA channel target in the monitor controller view. Choose the LFA channel and click on the LFE plus 10 decibel option to set the recommended target. For multi-channel speaker measurements, make sure to check channel mapping during the hardware setup stage in the Measure app. The channel mapping in UAD console may differ from the Measure app for some multi-channel layouts, so it's important to verify that the correct output channels are assigned using the test tones and selecting the correct output channel. Note that the sample rate setting is limited to 96 kHz or below for monitor correction to function on Atmos setups such as 5.14, 7.16, or 9.1.6. Once measured, save the profile, load it in SoundID Reference, and apply it to Apollo as before. Note that while all active channels are calibrated for multi-channel profiles, the monitor correction view displays the front left and right correction curves only. Reminder, multi-channel profiles, 2.1 and above, require a SoundID reference for a multi-channel bass license. Multi-channel profiles created in a free trial will stop functioning unless a multi-channel license is activated. Now that we understand how to apply calibration profiles to Apollo X, let's take a moment to answer some questions regarding functionality, performance, and workflow. What's included with the calibration profile, and what filter type is used. The profile export will include the calibration profile itself and the following DSP features: dry-wet, target mode, safe headroom, listening spot, and limit controls. Based on our individual needs, we can make adjustments to these settings. For example, the target mode can be changed from flat target to translation check. For this demonstration, we will use a smartphone average target curve. Once the adjustments are made, we'll need to apply the calibration profile again for the changes to take effect. Note that virtual monitoring is not supported for the Apollo monitor correction, so this setting will not be applied. Additionally, keep in mind that the filter type does not apply to the integration, as the processing takes place on the Apollo X DSP using Universal Audio's own processing and filter solution. The Apollo X DSP uses minimum phase, IR biquad filters for the integration, with 24 filters per each satellite channel and 5 filters for the LFA channel. What is the performance? Once the calibration profile is applied to the Apollo DSP, the calibration performs at near zero latency. The total added latency by the integration is around 1 millisecond, depending on the sample rate setting used. In terms of the DSP load on the Apollo X interface running two calibration profiles simultaneously, for example, a headphone profile and a stereo speaker profile with bass management, takes up around 13% of a single DSP core. Running a 9.1.6 multi-channel profile takes up roughly a single DSP core. For context, the Apollo X desktop devices feature 2 or 4 DSP cores, while the rack unit models feature 6 cores. Can I use 2 Apollo X devices at the same time? If you have multiple Apollo X devices connected, calibration profiles can be applied to the primary device only. The integrated output channels of secondary devices will not be available. To apply a profile to the other connected device, simply assign it as your primary device in the UAD console hardware settings. Open console and go to preferences. In the hardware tab, we can see 2 of our devices, Apollo Twin X and Apollo X16. If we change our primary device from Apollo Twin X to Apollo X16, SoundID Reference will be using this device as the main integration device. If a device is removed from the primary section, the profiles previously applied to it will stop functioning. Can I quit the SoundID Reference app after applying the profile? Yes, the app can be shut down, as the calibration profile is now stored within the Apollo. However, the app will be automatically launched by the UAD console as part of the integration when you reboot your computer. It is recommended to keep the app running, as it allows us to make quick profile and settings adjustments and reapply them as needed. Keep in mind that the SoundID Reference virtual audio device is closed down automatically upon applying the profile to the Apollo and is no longer available on the operating system level. In other words, the app now acts as a control interface only, requiring insignificant processing resources. Additionally, you might want to keep the app at hand to switch from the Apollo to another output device as needed, using a regular non-integrated output preset. This will reinitiate the SoundID Reference virtual audio device as a non-integration device is selected for use. For more details on the integration, see the article linked in the video description below. Subscribe to our channel for more support videos, and many thanks for watching.